Hello and welcome back to my blind playthrough of Bloodborne. I am in fact called Hollow, or so I will have you believe. And we're going to go down this elevator. Oh my god. Clothing physics. Clove physics. I meant cloth. God, it's creepy, isn't it? I like the fact that they're like really patterned. We gotta do a system update, guys. I'm sorry, I'm out. No, I'm kidding. They're really patterned snakes. It's funny, I thought they were a robot. I thought he sounded like a fucking robot when I first, like, met one of those enemies that have these snakes, like, bursting out of their head. Actually, now that I think about it, it reminds me of, you know those creepy squid tentacle guys? Yeah, they had like an incision on their head, right? They had like a cut, as if there was a mouth there. I feel like the snakes that are looking at me kind of like know that I'm here, and I think the snakes are going to grab me while I'm fighting him. It's kind of creepy to get near that thing. I wonder how it all works. Well, one day we'll find out. Alright, so I'm going to go this way, try this direction, but I am aware that I can go back into the windmill and jump down and go another direction. There are two paths for me to take here. I'm going to try this one first. And I'm going to try my best to remember that there are traps in this game. This forest, I swear to God, it's been the most Sen's Fortress out of all of everything in Bloodborne. Sen's Fortress was a sort of fortress, I suppose. The name kind of gives it away. Sen's Fortress was a fortress found in Dark Souls 1, and I believe the name had something to do with 1,000. Like, Sen's Fortress, it's like 1,000 traps. What the fuck? I ain't going near it. I'm gonna shoot it to death. Alright, it's gone. Disgusting. Alright, so that nearly died at 200 health. So I'm gonna go ahead and figure this'll kill it. I missed. Okay. Alright, we try again. There we go. Yeah. If 200 is just not enough to kill it, 500 plus is definitely enough to kill it. Alright, so there's these weird fucking snake things moving around, and we've seen that they're inside of the heads of the groundskeepers, I suppose. Yeah, that's what these people are. They're the groundskeepers of this area, and apparently I misunderstood a sentence that Alfred said to me. Oh my god, I'm not gonna get distracted. Okay, I'll talk about that in a sec. Yeah, so Alfred said something and I kind of misunderstood it, apparently. Basically, what he said was there's Bergenworth, which is a place of learning, like a college, and there's a tomb. And I sort of understood him and thought what he said was Bergenworth was a college for learning inside of a tomb. No. Two separate things, apparently. So there's Bergenworth and the Tomb of the Gods, which we've heard about before. Hunters have gone to the Tomb of the Gods many times before us. We've heard that from the first hunter, or the old hunter, Gaiman, who didn't seem really sure that that was his name, did he? He had a big pause between when he said his name, you know, when he said, oh, my name is Gaiman. It doesn't sound like that's his name to me, either way, but we won't get into that too much now. Point is, Bergenworth, College of Learning, and there's also the tomb. The question is, are we going to Bergenworth now, which is the College of Learning, or are we going to the tomb? Well, the indication to me right now would make me think the tomb, because there's a giant gravestone there. And that actually reminds me of the gravestone you see in the Hunter's Dream, the one that was all muddied and looked like there was footprints in it. Some viewers actually said that they think they're seeing the heads of the Great Ones, if that's what they are, rather than footprints like I saw. And now that I'm looking at it, those look like the heads of the Great Ones right there, sticking out that tree trunk. And there's more there. I wonder if, I can see something. Yeah, snake. I wonder if... There's another gravestone right here. I wonder if this forest was sort of like the original place, the origins of the Great Ones, or something to do with them, because we can clearly see these pinecone-type things that look just like the Great Ones' heads. Are those statues dedicated to the Great Ones even here in the forest? Or is that just like, I don't know, part of the forest naturally, and they took inspiration from that? I don't know. Why is it that we're seeing the heads of the Great Ones popping out of the ground like this? That's the question that I want answered. Is that an executioner near me, or is that that weird snake thing breathing? I'd say it's an executioner, because I'm still hearing the sound. I'd love for one of these snakes to drop, like, something. I'm hitting these all the time because I'm like, is it alive? Look at that. Look at that. That's one of the Great Ones. These look like either statues. Yeah, well, hang on. Look, it's cracked right there. It's not made from flesh. It's made from stone. They're statues of the Great Ones. Okay, they're not like a natural thing coming out of the side of these trees. Specifically, they're statues created by people. Whether it's men that made them, I don't know, but they're statues. Alright, it has venom. Do you see that? It's either a curse or, more likely, venom. I cannot let it hit me, and it makes sense because it's a snake that it would have venom. I'm going to go ahead and use a blood vial. I have plenty to store, so even though I didn't lose that much health, it's still fine for me to do that. Keeping my eyes open for these traps. There appears to be a bunch. I'm going to favour the power attack with a two-hand because it's one-shotting them. I prefer using the jump attack to kill these guys quickly, but the thing is, it's not killing them. It's just missing their kill shot by about, I don't know, 50 damage points. So it's just more efficient for me to use that power attack. Even though I do use it a lot. It's just a very good power attack, isn't it? One of the best in the game, at least to my experience so far. Alright, so that's like a side passage I could have taken. Behind this giant fucking gravestone that looks identical to the ones that we saw in Hunter's Dream. I want to know, what is the purpose behind the gravestones in... in the Hunter's Dream that you use to teleport around? Like, how do they function? Something that I actually really want to discuss today is, in Demon Souls, you are essentially a ghost bound to the Nexus, which is your hub where you constantly return to. And you are essentially a ghost when you're running around in the world. The more you die, the more ghostly you become. Right? And it was known as a curse type of thing. In fact, not a curse. It was just like a... it was a plague or something like that, right? Not a curse. Curse was the wrong word, right? In Dark Souls 1 and 2, you were undead. And it was like a zombie. You would die and come back, but you'd be more hollowed. Yes, I see the ironicity. That's what I tried to say there. See the irony in me being called hollow and me loving Dark Souls games. Madman's knowledge. Madman's knowledge right next to this creepy-looking gravestone. I'm not surprised. What did he know? What did he learn from that gravestone? This area is very big. There are many paths for me to take. I'm trying to take it slowly. Whoa! Holy shit! What the fuck? What kind of... what game am I in, man? is this Resident Evil? Am I in Resident Evil? And instead of snake, instead of like creepy tentacle monster things, it's snakes. Is that what's happening here? Because it's very similar. It's creeping me the fuck out, man. Resident Evil, one of my favorite game series as I was growing up, and it fucked me up as a kid. Like, it creeped me the fuck out. I mean, it was zombies, so can you blame me as a kid? Remember the first Resident Evil game I played was a demo on PlayStation 1. Scared the bejeebus out of me. These gravestones, man, they are suspicious as fuck. You right there, mate? That was close. It's not worth using my one hand on these guys. If I can one-shot them, I'll one-shot them. Oh, they finally dropped loot! Ugh. Just hoping for some sort of, like, item that would give me some lore. We have another, wanderers, I'm gonna call them there. The body that's combined with the snakes. I wonder if I die, they'll, like, use my body like that. Or maybe even, they've got, like, a grab attack that has that effect on my character's body. God, it's gross. Alright, so it has to be a fully charged attack, otherwise it doesn't kill them. Ow. That did not do much damage to you. Oh, grab attack right there. There we go. Yeah, it wasn't worth the risk to get, like, what was that? 4 damage to finish him? No thanks. Got that heal back now. It's a shame the quick power attack is doing 1 damage too little to kill them. So it'd be a very efficient and quick way to kill them, wouldn't it? Just be doing this instead of doing the full charge. God, look at all these gravestones. But the ones that I'm more interested in with these weird patterns, it's almost like parasites or worms or fish. That's what I see. What do you see? I see the face of a great one there, actually, covered in some sort of white pattern. Rather than footprints now, after that comment. And I can see it, you can see. They're like, they're almost like hives on their head. They remind me of beehives. You know, they're like the cocoons, or whatever the actual word for the hive is. You know, where all the honey's stored in these little, like, cells or rooms. I apologize, my bee knowledge is quite lacking. I don't know the actual names for these things. Do let me know in the comments if you're a bee expert. A bee-spurt, perhaps? Is that the cool way to say it? Probably not. Is there a way to say bee expert in a cool way? Probably not. So I can still hear that big, deep, guttural breathing, and it seems that it's actually on this plateau above us. Aha! I knew it was an executioner. We just saw his axe that gave him away. I bet he jumps down on you if you go too near to that cliff face. It would appear that this is everywhere. I'm looking for the secret route that leads me up to that guy. But I honestly don't think there is one. I think I might have to go a different way to get up there completely. Kind of a quick look around. Look at this. So I had a quick look around. I was like, there's got to be a way to get up there. This is up here where the bridge is, leading to the first snake man we encountered. Technically second, I suppose. And over here, we have this this little jumpy bit. This rolly bit, I meant. Where we can get up to the plateau in which the executioner resides. Some big, big trees here. Creepy ass trees. So, I'm thinking this area contains a boss. Some sort of snake-based boss. You're alright, mate. You seem very lonely up here. And get on the ground. I love that. The fact that it kills them, glorious. And all that was for some extra stone shards that I definitely don't need. But I suppose it's good to have the free vials. I cannot complain having more of those. It was worth a small piece of my time to acquire those. Ah, some loot that I would have otherwise missed. Just some more shards again. Ooh. Look at this. So the only other time we've seen water was at the bottom of Old Yharnam, in the valley. It was a very small, like, stream. It was basically nothing. And we saw that huge lake back at Old Channel Lane, Hemwick Lane, rather. At the very back of it, near the huge building. And, yeah, this is the next big pool of water we've seen. And it kind of gives you, an idea of where you are in the world. How close you are to a coastal area. And I honestly couldn't say whether this is the coast or not. And this leads out into an ocean or sea. Because we did see a wall around that lake. You know, and that's also where we got the lake symbol, the rune. So I don't know whether that's just a big lake that I can't see the other side from due to the mist, or maybe we are in fact on the very coastline, which is quite the interesting thing to consider. Is that cobweb? So the point that I was making earlier, the nexus is what binds you, and you come back and back again like a ghost in Demon Souls. In Dark Souls 1 and 2, there's a curse in which you are somewhat of a zombie, I suppose. Now, the question is, how does it work in... Oh, nice, the one hit. 700 damage. It must have been a counterattack, that. Pretty good. I was wondering, how does it work in this game? You know, we're hunters, right? And we return to the dream every time. Are we dead? Are we bound to the hunter's dream like we were in, to the Nexus in Demon's Souls? And this probably doesn't have anything to do with the lore or reason behind this or anything of that nature, but I think it's interesting to note that the voice actor for the priestess that helps you level up, she is actually voicing the puppet, the doll that we interact with in this game. She's the exact same voice actor. She sounds like exactly the same. And in the world right now where we're questioning, are we alive? Are we dead? How is it that we keep returning? You know, we're a ghost in Demon Souls. We're a zombie kind of in Dark Souls. So what is it that keeps bringing us back? You know, we say that we return to the dream. But dreaming doesn't cause immortality. What is causing this immortality we seem to have? Look how far away the moon is, by the way. I'd like to know. What are your theories, guys? Can't really see any islands. Maybe this is the coast. Maybe that does lead out into the ocean. Maybe we were on an island. I don't know. Alright. So, oh my god. There's a big thing over there. There's another one down there. I don't want to do this, man, but it's time for me to man up and kill me a snake. Oh my god, it looked away. It looked away! Ah! Fuck me. Oh god. Alright, I tried to get the follow-up power attack and it didn't work. Okay. It actually looked away, which gave me the advantage. If I want to be annoying, I guess I could do that again. Right? Make this an easy kill. Don't risk anything. And just have it turn around. Like so. It's easily possible. And now it's dead. God, it's just like a ginormous amount of snakes hurtling around each other. And there are a couple that are bigger, but most of them are quite small and thin snakes. What is causing them to stick together like that? We got a murky blood gemstone there. A blood gem that fortifies weapons and add various properties. Blood gems needed most reticle. What does it even do? It's a level 7. It adds slow poison. It adds poison to your weapon and also some physical damage, which is not bad. But poison. Apparently arcane works like this. Let's say I have a huge arcane stat, but no fire or poison or bleed or anything of that nature on my weapon. My arcane is having no effect on my weapon. Let's say I have a huge amount of strength and my weapon scales with strength. And I put like a fire. Clear deep sea. Well, that thought's gone now. I was asking if that's the sea. This is my indication that it is in fact the sea. This transcription of the Great One's inhumane voices depicts down-reaching currents. This rune means deep sea and grants augmented resistance. Great volumes of water serve as a bulwark guarding sleep and an auger of the Eldritch truth. Overcome this hindrance and seek what is yours. Just like the lake rune, we see that the water is known as some sort of cell. Yeah, it's almost like a prison for the dream. Is the dream in the water? Is something contained by the water? Is something in the depths down below? Maybe. We managed to stumble into that behind this giant gravestone, what once again looks like a bunch of Great Ones' faces etched onto it. Many, many questions, guys, today. Many, many questions. As always with Souls games. But you gotta love it, man. I absolutely love it. Got some more red gravestones. Why are they red? Why are they glowing? I don't know. Look at it, man. It looks so creepy. Next big mother trucker's over here. Surrounded by about 50 gajillion snakes. Been a long while since I've used Molotovs, so since I've got a huge store of them, I figured why don't I make use of them. In a situation like that, Molotovs made it much easier for me to survive, to thrive. So I figured why not, and look how much easier that was. Imagine if I tried to wade into that, I would have got hit a lot. Since I have a lot more actually hiding away in my stash, I'm sure I can replenish my stock of Molotov cocktails easily. They're on top of a dead horse. I don't think they were eating that. I don't think they set it on fire either. Hearing some weird sounds around me, man. I was looking at those vines, those tree trunks there. The roots of something. I was thinking, is that a giant snake? Is it going to grab me? It's just the root of a tree. A stump of a big tree next to that huge gravestone. Like, why are they so big? Any area with the Great Ones in them unnerves me. What the? Where did you come? Were you, like, on top of the tree or something? Clever girl. Gotta make them Jurassic Park references, guys. There was a new sneak peek trailer thing of the new Jurassic Park film, and I cannot wait for it. Chris Pratt is one of my all-time favorite persons, and I wanted to see him do well, and the film looks good. Alright, so there's another snake somewhere over here, looking in the trees because one ambushed me now. There's also that loot that I can get to, but kind of get back from it. Also, there's that. Some sort of head or something moving around. Let's go see this snake. It appears to be stuck and it's being very loud. Sorry, hang on. The way those were moving in the wind. I was like, is that a load of snakes? I'm starting to see shit now. Is it a trapped snake or am I hearing a lot of snakes? Oh. Oh god. Oh god, I should have saved my Molotovs. Shining coins. Oh. I heard his footstep, and I just rolled. I'm glad I did. Get away from me, you son of a bitch. Just barely reached him. Oh my god, that. Oh my god! he was put there so when you were stood here, he'd push you off. He even did a really long attack using a snake there. Those fucking bastards, man. You're right, mate. Got some snakes on your head there. You don't look too good. That counterattack, though. He barely takes any damage from any other hit besides the fully powered charge. It's crazy. Counterattacks definitely do some nice damage to this fellow. Bloodstone chunk. The first bloodstone chunk that we found. A solid chunk that forms in cold blood. So we have the original shard, the twins, and now the chunk, which is just four sort of like combined into a chunk. After death, a substance in the blood hardens, and that which does not crystallize is called a bloodstone. A chunk will never appear in the blood of any ordinary human. Seek deadlier foes if bloodstone chunks are needed. So even these guys are not deadly enough to be considered worthy of bloodstone chunks. What the hell are we going to have to kill for chunks? I assume that's going to put us up to +9, and then we're going to need, like, I don't know, like a slab to get to +10. But we're getting there. Alright, so I believe the clever thing to do here is, well, I'll get rid of this because I'm not going to be using it that much. Now, I haven't used one of these ever. I want to oil these bastards up. I missed, but I did hit one. I missed, son of a bitch. Basically, I want them to burn. See that? That did some nice damage, but I wasted a lot of time missing. Fuck. Alright, so I'm back up here. Just grab some loot up at the top of this hill here. That big snake that I killed with Molotovs. Actually, I didn't kill this one with Molotovs. I stabbed it in the back, sort of like making it go back to its original point. It's kind of a cheesy kill, but this is the area I'm in now. And I just need to make sure I don't embarrassingly die, I suppose. You attack too much and too quick for what you are, you son of a bitch. It's very inconvenient, but whatever, that was a good kill. So we've got some more murky gemstones there if we want to get some poison on our weapons, for example. So that's where those two are. The third one has its shit out. Try and push me in, so I'm gonna try and trigger it. It's not coming over here. Alright, there's no reason to take three of them unless they have my souls, maybe echoes even. But I'm concerned that one of these has them, because that means it makes more logical sense. So one will come out on its own. I just don't trust this area right now. I haven't cleaned it. Oh my god. Oh my god. Nope. 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 There's too many around me, man. I can't fucking... I don't feel safe in any direction. Not a single direction feels safe. Holy shit. This is fucking tense. But I'm gonna work my way through it patiently and one step at a time. That might have been two steps at a time. Alright, next is this big motherfucker. Note to self. You cannot stagger them. Stop trying. Damn it, so close. But be careful, I reckon they'll do a lot more damage when they actually poison you. It seems like they don't do that much damage on hit. It's the poison that gets you. Perhaps. Though they do a lot of swings in quick succession. So maybe that's where their damage comes from, more specifically. Remember that there was that loot that I could drop down into? Still thinking about that. We have one guy down here. Not sure if he's a snake, man. I can't really hear the hissing of his snakes. We have a gate that we can unlock. I'm questioning where the next shortcut is, / next lantern. Because it's quite far, this. And I would say I need one. Yeah, I would agree with that notion. Every time I pick up loot, I'm like, alright, where's the ambush? This forest. God, I haven't been this on edge. As much in Bloodborne until now, I think. I want my echoes back, guys. And you know I ain't fighting both of you at the same time. You know it's not going to happen. Alright, I couldn't feel safe. I just couldn't feel safe until I came up here and killed these three. I didn't want them coming up behind me. I just did not want that. So I went up here and I took them down. Turns out that was all the cocktails I have, unless I need to go back and get more. And it would appear that my echoes are down here, in fact. Which is inconvenient as hell. Especially as I have spent my resources when it comes to molotovs. I honestly thought that shot was going to poison me straight up. They're not as bad as they look, I suppose. Their badness comes in numbers. And their poison. Again. So poison resistance clothing. Probably very good here. And I'm pretty sure I do have some. The question is this the poison resist gear? Or something else? I should go check. Ow, son of a bitch. I would think that this is the poison resistance gear. Based on how much poison they're doing to me. Let's have a quick glance through at the stats. Yeah, the reason I'm not getting poisoned by these guys as much is because these special church doctors are immune to poison. Or not immune. Wrong word. They are resistant to poison. As you can see, this snake is in fact the one with my echoes. You can see the big head on the right has them. Oh, that was a pain in the ass. But we got them back. 40k echoes is worth the pain. Deep sea. Wow, we really are seeing a lot of this water-related rune stuff, aren't we? So you have lake, clear deep sea, and now deep sea. This transcription of the Great One's inhumane voices depicts down-reaching currents. This rune means deep sea and grants augmented resistance. Great volumes of water serve as a bulwark guarding sleep and an auger of the Eldritch truth. Overcome this hindrance, just like the other ones. All right. So, what does this even do? Physical damage reduction 3%. Frenzy resist 2%. 200%. I guess that's like the poison stuff. Add slow poison resistance. Resistance to poison. Pretty good, but I have the clothing for it. Luckily, I happen to have this equipped when I came into this area, and I suppose the reason it's in the area is because, well, the doctors needed the poison resist if there was snakes living in this area. Perhaps these snakes have been living here so long that the doctors just knew about them and took control of the situation and made some sort of not necessarily a cure. What the fuck? Oh. So these summon more. Very interesting. Now the question is, if I'm too... Oh boy, just out of range, eh? That's depressing. If I had to kill... Am I to kill you? Will they disappear? No? He simply summons them. And you must fight them. Oh, is that a pig? What are you doing here, piggy? You have no business here. The hell? These aren't so bad. I've improved when it comes to defeating these guys. Using a power attack on them is fine and all, but I can kill them in huge numbers if I wish. What the fuck are you doing here? Where do these pigs come from? You know, I can give them these exams all I want. But I still would like to know their origins of these pigs. They give you lots of vials, I suppose, but what causes these pigs to be so huge and violent? Why are they where they are? We had one in the jail area. We had one... Oh, I can climb this. Haha! Alright. We had one in the jail area, we had one in the sewer area, we had one here in a forest. Ooh! Grave guards! Very interesting, I've not seen this at all. Look very, reddy, orange kind of thing. Yeah, look at that. Robe of Doris, grave guard of the Forbidden Woods. Countless bloodied ritual tools hang from its back. Willem kept two loyal servants back at Bergenworth. When they were sent into the labyrinth, they encountered the Eldritch Truth and went mad. One became the password gatekeeper, while Doris became a grave guard of the forest. Both remained loyal even in madness. Despite turning batshit insane, they were still loyal to Willem. Very interesting. So we had one that was the password gatekeeper that we've met, that's super dead, yet still keeps the password beyond death. And we have the other one, Doris, who was the guard of the graveyard. So this is a graveyard. And whether he's alive or dead now, we're not really sure. But we do have his clothes. And that doesn't mean he's dead. Having his clothes doesn't mean he's dead, I don't think. What's a suitable hat to go with this? The doll hat. No. What's a suitable hat? I mean... Colour scheme's off. Maybe a top hat? No. Just gonna go with this, it looks alright from the back. What's the stats like? We didn't even, like, acknowledge the stats. Better poison resist. Better most things on this. That's good frenzy resistance and beasthood. Interesting. Is there any more lore on any other pieces of this gear? No. Okay. Covered in the blood of untidy rituals. He did rituals. As you can see, it's covered in blood. We have, like, some tools and bags. Vials, water skin. It's kind of almost like, not like easternly clothing, but oh god, that was a bad miss. Like someone who lives in a desert is the way I view these robes. You might see them a different way, but that's what I'm seeing right now. Sort of desert robes, but I don't think there's a desert anywhere in Bloodborne. Although I could be wrong. Thought this was like a cave entrance, but no. Just a hollow bit. A bit of me, you see. Alright, where's that patrol guy? We led up there, we crossed the tree trunk. There is that area that I can drop down to. There's this pathway that leads up there. Let's try further down for now. Poke a little bit further. See what trouble we get into. It's probably not a good idea to be wearing the clothes I am when there's so much poison related stuff. And I have poison clothing. Ow. Even so, it wasn't that bad. There we go, the counter-attack there. Got the damage in. More shards. We can use that chunk to level up our weapon, I think. Although the first level might require 3. So, definitely not if that's the case. Sucks that it's just out of range of the kill, doesn't it? So I'm being more confident now when it comes to dealing with the smaller guys, the smaller snakes, because I'm used to them. Oh, we have some ghouls here. Some sort of swampy bit. I just want to point out that last episode we had... Oh, another pig. We had a swampy bit in town that had a bunch of ghouls in it. And I noted that the reflection of the moon caused the water to be multicolored. Ah, son of a bitch. Oh my god, it comes out of his hands as well. Creepy. Creepy. Yeah, it turns out that was oil. And if I'd walked a different way, like the path that I ended up taking, meant that I killed people on the roofs before going down into the swamp area, if you recall that. They were going to throw Molotovs down at me while I was in the swamp. And the swamp was essentially made from oil. Do you see the problem there? I would have burned to death. I would have burned so hard. So I was very lucky that I ended up going the path that I did. And I'm very pleased. So that just leads up the way we've come. This was just a pathway instead of going around like I did. There's still that drop where that loot is, which I'm thinking about still now. But let's keep exploring. So... down this side way, we have what appears to be the entrance to the swamp bit. You know, there was that drop that we were looking at. But we don't want to go on a massive fall damage-based drop, do we? We want to go down into it. I hear a pig. Why is there so many pigs? This is 3 pigs we've seen in this area. What the hell? Oh, what is that? I like these fireflies over the swamp. That looks very nice. Is that more oil? I can't tell yet. I don't think it's relevant. There's light over there. Perhaps an entrance? God, this place is huge. There's just so... oh, loot. There's just so much for me to miss. So much for me to explore and talk about. God damn. I'm going to have to leave it there, guys. It's 50 minutes into this episode. Obviously, I'll edit out a little bit, but it'll be about that time frame. So I'm going to have to leave it there. Thank you so much for watching. Do talk about those things that I talked about. You know, a lot of lore questions like, you know, what binds us to the Hunter's Dream and stuff. Is that something I might learn in the future? You know, is that a spoiler? Maybe, I don't know. I want to avoid spoilers if I can. But... point is, there's a lot for us to talk about, lots to think about, and I've pushed through this area feeling like I'm making good progress, yet there's still so much to go, it seems. It's just like, will it ever end? This woods is massive, and I kind of like it, actually. I like the big area. So, thank you so much for watching. If you've enjoyed the video, do leave a like. It helps massively. If you share these videos with people you might think find them interesting, I am hugely grateful, guys. There have been a lot of new subscribers for the Bloodborne series. Hello and welcome. Do check out the other things I do. I'm doing some GTA stuff right now, and my god, I'm putting a lot of effort into those, and people are really enjoying them. But either way, you look at my channel at your own, I guess, choice. Either way, I'm absolutely loving doing Bloodborne. Really fucking grateful to have so many viewers who are so dedicated to the series. You know, the art, you've seen the artwork Ethos and Pathos is doing, absolutely beautiful. And not just that, all of the sort of like viewer involvement, you know, we've seen artwork from other people as well. There's Ethos and Pathos. And it's been absolutely brilliant, guys. So thank you so much for watching, and thank you for your great involvement. Even those in the comments discussing lore, having your conversations, you know, making the best of this game. And it's wonderful to have a community like this. All right, guys, enough being weird. All right. I will see you guys next time. Have a great day.